in the past, I have been working with some school, elementary school, through projects that my student did to outreaching the school. At the point was proposing Italian for fifth or sixth graders and through storytelling, through the creation of short stories based on the Italian children literature. So my students have prepared some vocabulary game, mazes, matching, different type of fun games that add vocabulary retrieved from the stories.
We do a lot of collaboration. And like Gisella touched on, we have students of all levels of engagement, right? So this is one way that we can ask students to be accountable for their work, because you can see, you know, the edit history, for example, if you're working on a Google Doc. But it's also a way to give immediate feedback. They can put links and images, and of course they have their narrative there, and then I can go in, I can add my comments, and they can correct it. And so it's a live collaborative document, and I think that's really, really important to create that atmosphere online.
I have a different approach. I'm new to Google Sites. She is the queen of Google Sites, Megan. And I'm using it for the first time, but I thought that it would be a great tool because it becomes also a container where your organizational skills get laid out very well. And I tend to be quite organized in doing things. And the purpose of this project is just not doing a project, but from our side, teach our students to be creative. That is the limit of this online education, that focus more on completing the assignment than on the enjoyment that the traditional classes has. We need to take risk, and that can be controlled in a certain sense. It's not a jump in the empty, in the emptiness, you know, but we need to take risk, you know, to adapt and to try to deliver in the best way we can for the cause.
Yeah. And I think it's fine. I've never had an issue with my students. When I try something new, I jump in to emptiness all the time. And sometimes I fail. And I've never had students laugh at me or get angry at me. And I just say, oh, I tried something new. It didn't work. And they're like, better luck next time. And I think it is a good model for our students too. So really, we can't be afraid as educators to fail also.